we turned a little to the left, and entered a beautiful and fertile plain, bounded on one side by the sugar canes, behind which rose a wood of palms, on the other side by the bamboos, and before us was Cape Disappointment, backed by the ocean, a magnificent picture. We at once decided to make this our resting-place. We even thought of transferring our residence from Falcon's Nest to this spot, but we dismissed the thought when we reflected on the perfect security of our dear castle in the air. We contented ourselves with arranging to make this always our station for refreshment in our excursions. We loosed our animals, and allowed them to graze on the rich grass around us. We arranged to spend the night there, and, taking a light repast, we separated on our several employments, some to cut sugar canes, others bamboos, and after stripping them to make them into bundles and place them in the cart. This hard work made the boys hungry. They refreshed themselves with sugar canes, but had a great desire to have some coconuts. Unfortunately, there were neither monkeys nor crabs to bestow them, and the many attempts they made to climb the lofty bare trunk of the palm ended only in disappointment and confusion. I went to their assistance. I gave them pieces of the rough skin of the shark, which I had brought for the purpose, to brace on their legs, and, showing them how to climb, by the aid of a cord fastened round the tree with a running noose, a method practiced with success by the savages, my little climbers soon reached the summit of the trees. They then used their hatchets, which they had carried up in their girdles, and a shower of coconuts fell down.